most cases, if you have two pieces of knitting that need to be connected to each other, you're going to sew them using any of the stitches that I explain under mattress stitch or stitching two sides together or tops or whatever. But in some circumstances, you can actually knit them together. Here are the circumstances. Your stitches in both pieces that you want to connect have to be live, which means they're still on the needle. I guess when you bind them off is when you kill them or something, but I guess live meaning, you know, that they could still unravel. They're live. You also have to have exactly the same number of stitches in both pieces. If you have those two things, then you can do what's called a three-needle bind-off. It's not as dainty a seam as when you sew two tops of your work together, but if you just despise sewing, this might be a good way to go. Some people will do a three-needle bind-off this way, and then it'll make like a big kind of scar at the top of the work with the right sides facing. But a better idea is to do it like this with wrong sides facing, so that that little scar will happen on the inside. So three-needle bind-off is one that you definitely can do if your yarn is still attached to one of those pieces of fabric, as in this case, I have this. You make sure that both pieces of fabric are on your needles. Probably at one point you would have finished one of these and put it on a stitch holder and then transferred it back from the stitch holder onto a needle. And then you need a third needle because, hey, it's called three-needle bind-off because you need three needles. So those stitches are on these two needles, and then with the third needle, I'm going to knit through the front stitch and the back stitch at the same time. So I'm inserting my needle into this front stitch as if to knit, and I'm inserting it into the back stitch as if to knit. And then I'm going to wrap my yarn and pull up a loop. Then those guys can go off. I'm going to do the same thing with the next stitch. Insert my needle into both of those stitches. Wrap my yarn and pull it through both. It's not called a three-needle knit together, it's called a three-needle bind-off, because the next thing you have to do once you've done two of these is take the first one and lift it up and over the second one so that you bind it off, meaning now there's only one stitch left. So now the next one, I'm going to insert my needle knitwise into these two stitches, pull that up, and then I'm going to take this loop and carry it over that loop, sort of standard bind-off procedure, and go on. We do a couple more of these so I can flip it over and you can see what it looks like on the other side. You can only do this with the tops. There isn't any way to do this with like the sides if you try to connect two sides because you need these live stitches. All right, so let's look at what we got. Here I've been doing my knitting together. I knit the two layers together at once and bind them off. So now on the other side, I have, you know, a pretty nice looking seam. It's very nice looking. Like I said, it can be a little bit bulkier than the sewn seam. But there you have it, three-needle bind-off.